Hello, I'm Mr. Army. You're a retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. And I teach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia free. And here I'm rendering exposition of Matthew 5, verse 17 to 19. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Pabram, the same thing, you know, supernatural, the highest, delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in my own native language we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Pabram, that dwells in his most beautiful temple, this one, of God, our physical body, created not by the human hands, but by the greatest artist, the demiurge potter, the lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda. They are the lords of the nature. Whatever you see with two naked eyes is created by them. The soul inside me is of Elohim, represented by the angel prophet Elijah. So prophets are witness to the light. They are not the light. They are not saint. They are angel. My God is Yahweh. Elijah means my God is Yahweh. And it is called Harmandir. This is called Harmandir, temple of God. Or Emmanuel. God is with us. If you are not a greedy person. If you are greedy, cheating people, then Satan is here. God is out. So you have to worship God in truth and in spirit, as Nanthiel was doing, according to St. Matthew 5, verse 17 to 19. Jesus said to his twice-born laborers, twice-born solitary virgin laborers, and not the once-born disciples of the rabbis. Remember that the temple priest, when they were sacked, the parable of wine press, they could not do any other job. So they enter the church of God with the Torah in their under their armpit. So they start making people read Torah again. Whereas the Torah in the New Testament is forbidden, because our covenant is of Holy Spirit and not of the dead letters. The Holy Spirit covenant finished with John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. And no spirit, no dead letters after that we go by the Holy Spirit. Children, they do need this one. So the laborers are not the firstborn disciples of the rabbis that are spiritually blind, because they do what the rabbi tells them to do, as Saul was doing, although his conscience was hitting him, you know, what you are doing is wrong. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill it by giving the knowledge of the oral Torah that was missing among the saltless, unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh. That they were, you know, the Jewish people who became Jew outwardly, they became unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh. So that knowledge of the oral Torah was missing. Because if you are not born of water, you cannot be born of spirit. So the Samaritans, they were faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, and they had that knowledge. Just yeah, here it is. This is the tree of life, Matthew 13, verse 52. Jesus defined an ideal rabbi, moral teacher, with the owner of a house, synagogue, who bringeth forth treasures, old which is the scripture, and the new is the oral Torah. And this was missing among them because they were not faithful to Abraham, not faithful to Yahweh when they became Jew outwardly. If they become Jew outwardly, then you can't build their covenant with Abraham, because Abraham was not a Jew outwardly. He was Jew of heart. And outwardly he was of Semitic race. That is why the Egyptians are not Jew. These people are making, the temple priests were making them Jew outwardly. Unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, which we call tares. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. And they are getting bundled up in Israel today for final burning, expecting next year on 14 May 2023, atomic war. So they are nice people, you know, demonstration nation, but they have been misled by their rabbi. So they say the tree is dead without this top root, without the knowledge of oral Torah. Among the Samaritans, this tree was green because they had the knowledge of the oral Torah. Oral Torah lacks nothing. This one scripture, it lacks oral Torah. Without oral Torah, this is dead. So this is the relationship between the gospel and the what is written moral laws. So if you then are knowledgeable, then you enter into the royal kingdom of God, which is this one, which Jesus opened the gate, narrow gate, for the solitary. Here, John the Baptist baptized Jewishmen in water in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father Yahweh. And then they sow the ego of the seed. You know, seed has ego. That I belong to this tribe, that tribe, and so, they have to sow it down to enter this narrow gate. Like a wheat plant, when you sow it, a plant come out, and that bears fruit. And that plant is the one which is seeking this narrow gate. When you enter this one, here you are plant, and not seed anymore. Seed is implicit. Our plant is explicit. So here we have one father with all his sons. Here everyone has his own mother and father. Here we have one father. We are all sons. That's why we are fishers of men, not of women. No woman here. No woman here. Woman here. Man and woman. So this is very easy to understand. You know, everything is in your heart. This knowledge is not in the books. If you look at something, this knowledge in the book, you won't find it, but it is so simple. That's why it is always preached face to face. So people can ask questions, you know. So let's carry on. So, missing among the saltless, unfaithful Paraman Yahweh, the Jew outwardly. Amen. I say to you, until heaven and earth pass away. Heaven and earth, that means whatever you see with true naked eye. Heaven and earth pass away, not the smallest letter or the smallest part of a letter will pass from the law. So law is perfect if you have the knowledge of the oral Torah. Until all things have taken place. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do so will be called least in the royal kingdom of God, or royal kingdom of Elohim. Allah Pabram, and that is, you know, he's not fit for that even. So even in the royal kingdom of heaven, even he's called least, you know. Never mind that one. So heaven, royal kingdom of heaven is different from the royal kingdom of God. So you can see that people, the Jewish people, they corrupted the Old Testament, especially on chapter on circumcision. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac, and nobody else can have it. But they were circumcising Gentiles, and anybody who paid them money, they were circumcised and make them the sons of Abraham. Because Abraham only circumcised Isaac, not Ishmael. That is the, not the, in the kingdom of heaven. So, that is corruptible. Kingdom of heaven is corruptible. Kingdom, royal kingdom of God is not corruptible. But whoever obeys and teaches these commandments will be called greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Kingdom of heaven means in the kingdom of rabbis. Among the rabbis, he will be the greatest. That's why Jesus told that leper who was Samaritan, who wanted to join Jesus, you don't need to join, go and stay in your family. Because they are rabbis, they were perfect. They had the knowledge of the oral Torah. And that's why the Samaritan woman at the well waited Jesus in Holy Spirit to proclaim that you are a prophet. And when Christ come, he will tell us everything. She was so knowledgeable. But the Jewish people hated them, as they hated the prophets in the past. That's why Jesus told when he was last journey to Jerusalem that, hey, Jerusalem, so many prophets came and you maltreated them. And when they died and people recognized their values, and then you built temples in their name to cheat people, to collect money from them. As Elisha, he cured Nama, a Syrian general. And when Syrian general bring present, Nama, Elisha refused to take it. That is a God's work yet unfree. And two greedy people followed him. And they took those presents from him under one excuse or the other. Most of the faithful salt of the earth, Samaritans faithful to Abraham, Yahweh, were a nation of prophets. They were a nation of prophets, you know. And the Jewish people was also called the nation of priests, but they were no more priests, and they were no more faithful to Abraham or to Yahweh. It's very interesting, and I wish people could be having seminar or something we can talk face to face, and I can iron out everything. By the way, this is the difference between kingdom of heaven and hell. This is the kingdom of heaven and hell of the rabbis in law and order. And this is the royal kingdom of God, which is inside your heart. So when Pilate asked him, what is the truth? What type of king you are? Then Jesus explained to him, my kingdom was like this one, like yours. My soldiers would have come to fight against you. But mine is this one, royal kingdom of God, inside my heart, not outside. So Pilate understood it and he told the Jew, hey, you have done nothing wrong. But they were, the Roman and the temple people, they were in collusion with each other. So they were not satisfied with his explanation and they told him, no, no, they want him to be killed. So after finding him not guilty, then tell me, how can he beat him? They say in the Bible that he was beaten by Pilate. How can Pilate beat an innocent man? No way. So this is a corruption. So many people are there. All these people who are reading Bible, they are spiritually blind because they don't ask question what is written. They don't question it because it's written that not a single all that, you know, nonsense. And what is written is corruptible. What is not, what you get from God is incorruptible. And God is inside you. And God teaches me what to say. I make mistake, He corrects me. Our Father, God blesses you.